hurry up, the fish pie is thawing, is a gimme, gimme, gimme quote. Why is shop-bought fish pie always awful? Okay. And these are just a few theories that I've got, but they do hold water, which is a bit of funny foreshadowing there. Well, first of all, it's because they don't hold water. It evaporates off. And fish is full of water. Who knew? Potato as well is full of water, and that just evaporates off, leaving this horrible, just tasteless, powdery sensation afterwards. This particular fish pie is, like so often fish pies are from supermarkets, an amalgamation of fishes, which they put in. And there's not how I make fish pie myself if I'm making it at home. And it's not the way my mum makes it. And I've actually done a video on making fish pie on my channel already. This one is smoked cod, salmon and king prawn fish pie. To me, that's not a fish pie. That's an Admiral's pie. Because you're putting all of the ocean in there. It's ridiculous. It always smells the same. The amount of ingredients they put in to bulk it up, but at the same time they'll cut back on. Because even though they put more in it to boost the flavour, at the same time, if it's too fattening, people won't buy it. The irony is, if you make it at home, you'll use fewer ingredients and it's probably more technically unhealthy. But because there's so many governments and organisations saying, oh, you shouldn't put that in there, that's going to make it too fattening, the food producers have got to listen to that rubbish. Meaning they're going to use inferior ingredients. If I'm making fish pie, I'll use double cream. I think in America you call that heavy cream. Proper full fat cream. Whereas in this one, they've used single cream. All the rest of the stuff they've put in it. I'm not showing you the particular brand this one is, because they are all the same. Tasteless, dull meals. And then added into it is the warnings. Now a warning, which is a death becomes a quote. Warning, although every effort has been made to remove all bones, some may remain. Warning, this is in bold and exclamation marked. So it's more, warning, this product may contain small pieces of shell. If it contains small pieces of shell, if I was making a fish pie at home, no it wouldn't, because I wouldn't be adding prawns and all the rest of it to a fish pie. And second of all, I've been making meticulously sure there'd be no bones in it, because I can't stand bones in fish pie or in fish in general if I'm eating it. I'm not fond of bones in fish. Now, let's give it a try. Also, the quality of the fish is also suspect, because not only is this one is particularly they've used cod, but so often they'll use pollock, which has a similar sort of texture to haddock and cod sort of fishes, but nowhere near as good in the flavour. But that particular fish is much larger, which makes it incredibly much cheaper to make ready meals out of. And also, I think, is what your fish burger's made of in Macadese. It's going to taste exactly how I know it's going to taste. Exactly how I expected it to taste. A strange sort of wall-paste, tasteless sensation going on in my mouth. It's not good. I love fish. I could eat fish pie every day of my life and I wouldn't batter an eyelid about that. But also in a microwave, the potato along the edges ends up burning. It's because all the water's just drained out of it, and then they'll use low-fat ingredients anyway, which means there's no fat and no water. So what you're left with is this bland nothingness. Because if there's no water and no fat, what is there left in the food? Just matter, isn't it? This is the grimmest food that I can imagine possible left after an apocalypse. If I walked into a supermarket and I was the luckiest one person alive because I was the only person in there, I can guarantee the last thing I'd eat is this flipping fish pie. It's grim. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know in the comment section down below. Scrabs. That means share, comment, rate and bell, subscribe. Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you love shop-bought fish pie? I know Linda LaHughes does off Gimme Gimme Gimme, but it's best to make it yourself. Fewer ingredients, full fat, done in the oven properly, so that even when you do freeze it, if there should there be any left over, it's always better. And to reheat fish pie when you make it yourself, put more cream under the bottom so that when it unfreezes in the microwave, defrosts. You're not really defrosting it because you're forcing it to unfreeze, aren't you? The fat in the cream will replace what is lost in water. You'll actually find that if you make fish pie yourself, if you freeze it and then reheat it, putting a little bit of cream in the bottom, it's very difficult to tell you that you've already frozen it. Whereas this, you can taste the frozen. Gordon Ramsay will be saying, that's frozen. And lots of people, when something's freezer bent as well, you can definitely taste it, but lots of people can't tell the difference. But I think that's because maybe they're used to it. When you stop eating it, it's like, I eat fish pie incredibly rarely. I bought this one to make this video because I know exactly how this is going to taste. It's going to taste awful. Even with bread, even tomato sauce, which I usually put in ready meals if they turn out not to be very nice, adding loads of tomato sauce can't rescue this abysmal meal. Scrabs, let me know in the comment section down below, am I wrong? Do you like shop-bought fish pie that's been frozen? Or even fresh? I even had a fresh one from Waitrose and it wasn't nice. It's because the ingredients are just always got some sort of dietitian looking over it or government figure going, oh no, there's too much fat in that, take it out. Leaving you with rubbish food. Anyway, I'm going now. Bye.